So if you're going to buy a, you know, a Ferrari, you're not going to be putting on the cheapest wheels and accessories. You're going to want to put on what is best suited to machine, obviously in our case, what the customer needs to get done.
Consumables. It's not a topic we always talk about, but there is real significance to having an inventory full of consumables to support the customers. Maybe no better example of that than walking through the Sodick facility here in Chicago and knowing the extensive growth that they have here in the U.S. and how they've incorporated the same idea across the country. I got Scott with me to talk a little bit more about consumables and the significance, not only for Sodick themselves, but for you, the viewer, as well. So Scott, a strange subject sometimes, but let's talk about consumables.
Yeah, a lot of people, you know, they realize the importance of the high-end machines, and we are definitely a high-end machine tool company, but they kind of overlook some of the added components that they put onto these machines. So if you're going to buy a, you know, a Ferrari, you're not going to be putting on the cheapest wheels and accessories. You're going to want to put on what is best suited to machine, obviously in our case, what the customer needs to get done. And there's many different options available depending on kind of what kind of materials they're cutting, workpiece heights, things of that nature, price concerns. So we take all that into account when we address consumables for our end users.
And let's expand a little bit, if you don't mind, Scott, on that supply chain issue and take it from having to jump a pond. Well, we've had those issues. And Right. Then maybe only having a limited inventory here in the U.S. where we are. You guys have actually expanded across the country to support this structure, haven't you?
Yeah, we have warehouses set up all around the country. You know, today is the Amazon culture. Everybody wants it in 2 days, right? So in order to be efficient with shipping prices and things like that, and as far as delivery or just-in-time needs for our customers, it's important to have warehousing around the country.
And as I think about it, and this is a cliche statement, maybe I say this too much, ladies and gentlemen out there, but I have to say it one more time. It feels like as I look around Sodick and I see the EDM machines, I see the milling machines, I see the additive and subtractive machining as well, I listen to you talk and I know the service and support. You guys have developed a kind of environment that allows someone to kind of go to one place and have most, if not all, of the answers for what they're trying to create in their facility.
Yeah, precisely, and that's why we have one individual assigned up for each one of the accounts. So they get to know that end user, and that end user can call in and not ask only for consumables, but he can call in and say, hey, I got a problem with my machine, or I need a spare part, or I got this question in cutting, and they can guide him in the right direction. So they're more of an account manager after they buy the machine from our dealer or from one of our direct salespeople. It's just a nice service to have so that customer knows, hey, I can call this one person and they can do all the running around for me. I don't have to worry about doing that. Huge added benefit. I think that's served our clients well.
Yeah, I do as well. Consumables, guys, who'd have known it's so important and valuable? Maybe you guys already knew, but learning from Scott, I see this relevance so significant. And now it just comes full circle and makes all the sense of the world. Consumables, maybe not such a strange topic to talk about. And thank you, Scott, for sharing your decades of wisdom with the MTD audience.
Thank you, Tony.